Namaskar. Welcome to the fifth episode of The Art of Rudraveena Making. Today, we'll be talking about Tumba. Tumba are these two gourds or resonators that are attached to both sides of the dandi. And their main purpose is to give you the volume, to some extent the sustain also, and also the tonal quality. And it's a very important part of this veena. And we'll also be talking about the different kinds of fretting system, the traditional fretting system and this kind of fretting system. So without further ado, let's get into this. Tumba. The first thing about tumba, what comes to our mind is how big should it be? Well, there is not a very hard and fast rule that the tumba has to be this big, because it grows from the nature, right? So all the time your preferred size might not be available. So most of the times we have to do with whatever tumbas are available in the market back right then. But usually starting from 50 inches to 55, 56 are easily available. If you want to go for a tumba as big as 60 inches or 65 inches, then you might have to wait a little bit. But also, there is another thing. There are actually so many things to know about tumba, and there are so many things to keep in mind while choosing the tumba. First of all, these tumbas are basically pumpkins. So when you get that pumpkin, you have to season it. Then there is a long procedure where I won't go into the depth how a raw pumpkin becomes this, but in short, what happens is once you remove everything from the inside and you season it, then we put a wooden lid on the top, and then for the decoration the leaves are added, and then it's colored, that's all. But when you get a tumba, the pumpkin, you need to check. Unlike the dandi and peacock and sharab, the thicker the pumpkin walls, the better. In my veena, the very first, this veena, on this veena, what happened was, my pumpkins were too thin. So when you have a thin pumpkin, obviously it sounds nice, but it's too fragile. It will just break. You don't know when. When you're making the lid also, it might break. But if you have a thicker tumba, thicker walls of tumba, it will give some more strength, and the thicker the wall, more bass resonances you will get from the tumba. So obviously for a Rudraveena player, it's always ideal to go for a thicker pumpkin for the tumbas. And then if you don't get pumpkin at all, there are different varieties. You know, right now in Saraswati Veena, no one uses the pumpkin tumba. After pumpkin, they have evolved a lot. They have tried wooden tumba, which I have seen in Rajshekhar Vyas's collection. He has wooden tumbas for Rudraveena. The only problem with that tumba is it's strong, it gives a beautiful sound, but it's too heavy to carry around. And it's so heavy, if you keep it on your lap, you will get a lot of pain and you can't keep it on your shoulder. Then the second stage was metal tumbas. Metal tumbas are also nice, but the only problem with metal tumba is they will give you a metallic tone. But it has a different character altogether, which is also nice. And then there are some veenas which are kept in different museums all over the country and also abroad. I have seen a veena in Kolkata Museum where the tumbas are made out of paper mache, and I inquired how that will sound from Rajshekhar Vyas. He said, yeah, it will also give a very good sound, but I haven't personally heard it, so I don't know how it might be. But there are Saraswati Veenas where this top tumba was made out of paper mache, and the advantage with paper mache is that you can decorate it so beautifully. If you're a good painter, you can paint the whole tumba so beautifully. It looks beautiful. Now, what is the ideal shape and size of the tumba? As I mentioned earlier, there is no hard and fast rule, but there are some guidelines that you can follow. That is, the inside of the tumba, the gap between the tumbas, there should be two rudras. If you have this two rudras gap between the two tumbas, it was kept in all the traditional style Veenas, but in Daga style Veena, it's kept two rudra and two or four fingers, like this, four or two. So why? Because if you are quite big in size, most of the Veena players are not so fortunate to have a figure like me. But in that case, what happens is it's a little bit difficult to fit into this kind of a size. So if you have a bigger space, it's just a little bit more comfortable. And traditionally, it's believed that if you have just exact two rudra gap between the two tumbas, it adds to the sound somehow. I don't know how, because this is the only Veena I have where I have got this two rudra. On this Veena, it's two rudra and two fingers, and on my big Veena, where I went extreme, there I have two rudras plus four fingers gap. And I believe to some extent having this two rudra gap adds, and it's true, because even though this Veena is quite small in size, it's still as loud and as resonating and as long sustenance it has got as my biggest Veena. And on that Veena I have tumbas of 58 inches diameter, and here I have only 50. So even though I reduced a lot, but still these tumbas are working fine, and the only explanation I can have because of that is this gap. And if you see, now if you go to a little bit mathematical part, I take the traditional Veenas as the standard, and now you can see you have this overall length as 11 rudras, and then you have two rudras here. This length is 7 rudras, right? Now the top tumba, this tumba, is supposed to be exactly under this ada. That is where it sounds the best. But on this Veena, I just kept it a little bit towards this side, and it doesn't hamper so much. And there are some Veenas where I have seen, okay, this is a little bit towards this side. And then this tumba should be exactly under where you pluck. And it can move a little bit here and there also, but usually if you have it exactly under where you pluck the strings, it will sound best. So usually this fret length, it's around 5 rudras. If you take that, you have 5 rudras between this clamp and this clamp. So, and you have 2 rudras here. So this half of a tumba should be around 1.5 of your rudras. So this overall tumba, ray should be 3 rudras. So in my case, if I have 5 inches long rudra, this ray is 15 inch, and that is where my tumbas will sound the best, and the Veena will be most ideal for my body. But there are exceptions. And then if you get smaller tumbas, there is nothing that you can do about it. And these ideal measurements were for the traditional Veenas. I repeat again. So on a Daga style Veena, as this really doesn't matter that much how, and you can go much bigger with those Veenas. You can go much bigger than how your ideal tumba size is. And usually on Daga style Veenas, it's never less than 55 inches, the tumbas. So, and all the best Venus, they have something around 57, 58 to 60 inches. And I have seen Venus which have 65, 64 inches kumbhas as well. So that's more or less about it. Now, let's shift to the frets part. For the frets, I have already mentioned a couple of times. On traditional Venus, you have these kind of separate frets. You have to cut them separately and then you have to round that from inside. And then those are tied with threads, nylon threads, just like this. But after you make that wooden fret, you have to add one metal chip like this. And that's kind of tricky. For me, I have never made this kind of frets and I don't know all the fine details about it. So I won't cover so much about those kind of frets, but I know what kind of problems these frets can give. There are juju kind of sounds, the strings might bounce back. Because it's so much difficult to control this length overall starting to end because there are so many things involved. So instead of that, I feel this system is much better. This porti system. What I have done here is, here are two wooden chips. And those are connected with three wooden pieces here. And this whole frame is sitting on the top of this. After doing this, what we have done is, these sides are tapered in a rounder shape, the insides. And then the whole frame sits on the dandy. And the better it sits, the better. And then just it's, connected to the dandy without any nail. The only thing we used here was glue and wood powder. You can use nails if you want, but I just didn't. And then it's colored. After that, you just have to get straight frets like this. Like for sitar, these same frets are carved in a certain way. You don't have to carve the frets. The only thing you have to look for here is the frets, these metal rods, they has to be straight and polished. And then you just have to tie them on this frame. And it does the job. And this system was first used by Shourindra Mohan Thakur, and that Veena is kept in Indian Museum in Kolkata. And then it was not used for a very long time, but right now, by the time when I went to Udaipur and started learning from Rajshekhar Vyas, he had also shifted to this system. And my husband, Murli Mohan Gowda, he is also using this system now. And obviously on all of my Veenas, I use this system, and there are so many others who use this system. And in the present days, this system on a Rudraveena was used first by Chris Dodridge. He is a wonderful Rudraveena player. So that's about it. But as you know, we can't say all the fine details and I can't show all the parts where everything was done because I couldn't photograph everything. And it's just a very general idea that I can give you here. And please keep on exploring and enjoy making your Veena and enjoy playing your Veena. Thank you.